Okay, so good afternoon, Mr. Ito. I will be presenting my appeal for chemistry. Okay, so today I will be presenting, or we'll be going over unit 2, 2.A through 2.E, the atomic structure and nuclear atoms. Students will be able to explain how the nucleus of the atom is much smaller than the atom, yet contains most of the mass. So, I got this from my exam, from unit 2 exam. Students will be able to explain how the nucleus of the atom is much smaller than the atom yet contains most of its mass. So for question number one, it says, if the atomic number of the element is 18 and it has an atomic mass of 40, how many neutrons are present in the atom? So how I answered this was that you have to subtract 40 minus 18 to get the neutrons.
Give that to me and I can definitely change that for you. Yeah.
Okay. So yeah.
Yeah.
That's how I got that. Absolutely. Next is 2.B. Explain the experimental basics for Thomas Thomson's discovery of the electron, Rutherford's nucleus atom, Millikan's oil drop experiment, and Einstein's explanation of the photoelectric effect. So J.J. Thomson basically discovered the electron.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how I got the answer. On my notes, like, I put Rutherford, Thomson, and Chadwick. Chadwick was protons. Rutherford was the nucleus, so I knew that Thomson's was the electrons. For 2C, explain how protons and neutrons in the nucleus are held together by nuclear forces that overcome the electromagnetic repulsion between the protons. The question was, why are enormous amounts of energy required to separate the nucleus into its component protons and neutrons, even though the protons in the nucleus propel each other? So I said D because I know that protons are the ones that repel. They have a positive they attract to the negative, and so I know that the neutrons don't have any, so the forces holding the nucleus together are much stronger than the portion between the protons. Point B, explain how some naturally occurring isotopes of elements are radioactive, as are isotopes formed in a nuclear reaction. What is the total number of protons contained in carbon-14 atom? So it says, what are the protons contained in carbon-14? So I know that to get the total number of protons, I have to look. I know that the protons and atomic number is the same thing, so I got this one because the atomic number is 6. radioactive decay, alpha, beta, and gamma, and know how the nucleus changes in each type of decay. So, is it okay if I read on the board?
Yeah, absolutely.
So, I know that this is positive, and it's 2, and it can be stopped by a thin piece of paper. Beta is negative, and it's a 0. Oh, this is a little fish. And a good way to memorize this was the 0 right here, and then the long stick as 1. Gamma is that, and it's 0, and it's the Y. So, for the most common types of radioactive decay, the most massive particle is the alpha. Good afternoon, Ms. Casillas. Today I will be presenting my integrated math 2. So for my homework completion chart, as you can see, I did 75% of my homework. If I needed help, I asked my peers or checked my notes or my homework and went back to it. For my assessment chart score, 90% of it was completed. I corrected my work by going back to my homework notebook, or if I needed help again, I would go to my peers. Whenever there was a test, I would study, no matter if it was as simple as a quiz. I would always go back to my notes and go over it with a friend. The mistake I did was that I wouldn't ask you for help. I would never like come to office hours, which will definitely be in my schedule for next semester. I'm going to present essential skill number 1, geometry basics. Oh, no. So geometric basics, learning target 1.2, angles and parallel lines. I will be able to use theorems to determine the relationship between specific pairs of angles. So my misunderstanding of this was when to put this part, the congruent, and when to put the M, or the measure. So for my quiz, like I said, I got everything right except for putting the M, which was my misunderstanding. I didn't know when and where to put it. And yeah, that's the same for that one. For my test, I corrected it by adding the M's, the measures, but on this side, I got one that said that it is supplementary, and you know how supplementary you have to put the addition because it's something plus something equals 180, and that's what I corrected. I think I deserve what I have, or at least like a low B or a solid B, because I feel like I did go over my notes and I did study when I had tests and quizzes and stuff, and I also went over it and went over it with my peers, and I asked for help with students, because I'm the type of person who like ask my friends first and then go to the teacher if they don't know. So that's what I did wrong. I didn't ask you personally. I didn't